87% of every real estate agent fails within their first year in the business. These are the 10 main reasons why. Number 10, they don't treat their business like an actual business. Okay, they don't operate from a P&L, they don't have their expenses, they don't have an LLC set up, they don't put themselves on salary. They're treating it more like a hobby. This is a real business, which you should treat it just as that. Number 9, they don't have a business plan. Okay, so they operate in a business, which it is, with no plan. They have no structure, they have no systems, they have no processes, they have no business plan, they don't know where their next deal is gonna come from. They operate every day, they try to figure out every day, and they find themselves completely overwhelmed. Number 8, they don't have a schedule. This is a big one. People leave their corporate world or they get into real estate as a 1099 independent contractor, and they think they can do anything they want. They have no schedule. They wake up when they want. They work when they want. The best agents in the business operate from a schedule the same way business professionals do. Number 7, they don't study the market. So it's really simple. I mean, you have to know your product if you're gonna win in this business. And I'm talking about winning big. I'm not talking about selling 2 or 3 homes a year. If you're gonna make $100,000, $200,000, $300,000, $400,000 plus per year, you need to become a market expert. Every month, you need to be going into your MLS and learning the most important stats in your market so that you can clearly articulate that to a prospective client. Next, number 6, they don't have someone coaching them and holding them accountable, okay? So I put a link right underneath this video. If you want to talk about working with me as your coach, I'd be happy to do so. And if it's not me, get somebody to coach, train, mentor, and hold you accountable. Coaching, the value of coaching is this. There have been people who have walked before you. There are people in this business that have succeeded at the highest levels before you. Wouldn't it only make sense? And this is the age-old rule of success. Go find somebody who has already succeeded doing what you want to do and ask them how. Ask them to show you. Get a coach. Next on the list, number 5, they have shiny object syndrome. This is so real. And if you're new or you've been in the business for a while, you know this to be true. Agents can't stick with anything. They try a new tactic or a new strategy for 30 days. They don't get results. They blame the strategy and they're off to the next thing. They spend their greatest hours, you know, researching and watching podcasts and YouTube videos and surfing Instagram for the magic pill, for the shiny object that is going to save their career. You've got to stick to one thing long term. Everything in real estate works. Prospecting works. Content creation works. Mailers work. Zillow works. Door knocking works. Open houses work. If you work, if you stick with the tactic or the strategy long term, you'll win. But you've got to give it enough time. I love this saying. The grass is green where you water it. You can always look up and say, oh, what is he doing over there? What is she doing over there? I wonder if that'd be better than what I'm doing, right? And then you go over there and try to do what they're doing. You're comparing your chapter 1 to their chapter 10. You see this agent in your brokerage that's been mailing a neighborhood for 27 years as a top agent. You send out one mailer to one neighborhood for 1 month, don't get a listing, and say, ah, mailers don't work. It's complete nonsense. Next on the list, number 4. They don't spend time working on their skills. This is a massive one. For most of the students in my coaching program, this is where we spend the majority of our time. Because most new agents to real estate are obsessed with what's the script? What's the strategy? Give me the words, Brandon. What do I say? I say this with much love and much respect. It's not that the words don't matter. It's how you deliver a message and how you make somebody feel that will cause them to do business with you or not. It is that simple. Your skills as a real estate agent potentially, in my opinion, is the most important thing. More so than what your website looks like, more so than what your business card feels like and what your logo looks like and all the things that agents obsess over, your skills are the most important thing in this industry. It will be the reason why you win. Next, number three, they have creative avoidance. Another thing that we see that causes so much failure in this business. Agents are doing and coming up with everything they can to get out of doing the actual work in this business, which is lead generation. You got into the lead generation business, you just happen to be a real estate agent. Creative avoidance means that you spend your days and your weeks and your months doing everything but the work, everything but generating business, everything but prospecting. Working on the website, working on your business card, obsessing over your logo. You know, all the things that you trick yourself into believing are mission critical, whether or not you're gonna win in this business, those things are not moving the needle. Don't get it twisted. Your job is to go out there and lead generate, generating new clients, new business. Never in my career, never one time, has a client not done business with me because they didn't like my logo. Never not one time has a client not done business with me because they didn't like my presentation folder or the material I used on the folder. Never not once did a client not do business with me because my website wasn't sexy. People do business with me and they'll do business with you based on how you make them feel and if they feel confident that you can get their property sold. Number two, they're a secret agent. This is just unbelievable to me, but there are so many, there's 1.6, 1.7 million real estate agents in North America right now, most of which are secret agents, meaning they won't pick up the camera, they won't hit play, they won't hit record, it makes them too uncomfortable, they're not willing to make content and put themselves out there on social media so they can start winning this top of mind awareness game with their database. They just won't do it. So they stay secret, no one calls them, no one reaches out to them to use them as a real estate agent, so therefore they're secret, they're hidden, just long enough till they find themselves going out of business. And then the number one reason why real estate agents fail is they end up making no money because they fail to prospect and look for new business on a daily basis. Let me make this super clear. Your job in real estate is to generate new business. Make no mistake about it. There will be people screaming from the mountaintops to do this and to do that and come to this and come to that. You are in the lead generation business. A day not prospected is a day not worked. So what I want you to do is, if you're new to this business or you've been in this for a while, watch this video. This is tips and strategies and advice that I wish that I had when I was a new agent that now I can share with you to ensure that you don't fail, to ensure that you succeed in this new career.